Hi everybody, welcome back to my session. I must apologise because last week I was told that the video actually cut out at one point, so hopefully that won't happen today. There's a camera as well. If you do have any problems, if you hit the little refresh button, that should solve the problem, I've been told. Okay, so can everybody hear me okay over at Cloth Cat? If you're there, hello. Anyway, I'm going to assume you can. Right, last week we started off, I started off with a disclaimer actually. I'm just going to read this to you. I have to read this, it's for your safety. If you're a child watching, please make sure your parents know what you were doing. You will be able to write comments while I'm live and leave comments once the stream is finished. Please do not mention your full name, your address, phone number or email in the sessions. And remember, keep the comments relevant and be kind. Do not engage with other people if you don't know them in person, and all comments are being monitored for your safety, and any abuse or inappropriate comment will be reported and people will be removed from the channel. I'm happy for you to tell me your first name. You can use an emoji flag to show which country you live in, but please don't put anything else personal on other than that. Again, it's just for your safety. Right, that's the boring bit done. So last week, if you haven't seen the previous video or any of the support videos that I've also added, if you go to back to the Cloth Cat channel and you go into the playlists, if you look in my playlist, which is Term 2 Songwriting, you'll see lots of different videos, including this one, which will be uploaded later on as well. And you can just have a look there, catch up. But further from last week, I started off by just showing you a little bit on my keyboard. So I'm just going to lift this up again. We started to write a song. I used an example of taking like a really simple song. It could be any song you like. It could be any pop song. I just took London Bridges Falling Down just because it's a good example. And we started off looking at using a couple of chords. So we used the C chord, D minor. And right at the end of the session last week, I did go on to cover E minor, which was the next chord along. So if you play C from the C note, C, D, E, F, G, A, B, C, that's the C major scale. And that's what we're sort of working around at the moment. So if you play the first note, which is a C, and then you play the E, which is the third note, and then you play the G, and you play all those three notes, that's a C major chord. If you move that shape along to the next bunch of keys, but you're playing the same shape, you're starting on a D, that's a D minor. Move it along again, and that's an E minor. Now, we're going to be bringing that E minor into the songwriting later on. As I say, this is just a quick recap. I was showing you those chords on the ukulele. If you remember, just pressing that one note there, which is the third fret along on the A string. I always have to think a bit harder with the ukulele because it's not the one I play all the time. That's a C chord. That was the A minor. Again, if you go to the previous video, I explain that. And then the E minor chord is fret number two, fret number three, and fret number four. So it's like that. It's like a diagonal shape. And that's E minor. Okay. But I'm going to jump on my old favourite, the guitar. So last week, we started off by taking... So London Bridge is falling down.
London Bridge is falling down, falling down, falling down. London Bridge is falling down, my fair lady.
And then I showed you how you can take the words of the verse and you can pretty much use a rhythm to rewrite your own verse. So if you, again, remember, I came up with
everyone is in lockdown, in lockdown, in lockdown. Everyone is in lockdown, it's not funny. And then we went on to play. There's no loo roll anywhere. There's no shampoo for my hair. There's no toothpaste. It's unfair. It's not funny.
And then, in a very sort of blundery way, I went on to show you how I just wanted to write an example of how you may be able to write down a melody if you don't read traditional music and you don't know how to write traditional music. So the idea was, if you follow the dots, it looks a little bit like a graph or, I don't know, a mountain range. We've got, it's a musical mountain range. So that would be the first note. London Bridge is falling down. And then we jump down here. Falling down. And then back to there. Falling down. So what I did was, we've now got the words. We're using, you know, the same music at the moment, though. So let's have a look at swapping that music around. So if we mess around with the melody, and what I've done, I've kind of reversed it. So if you imagine we sang it this way instead. London Bridge is falling down, falling down, falling down. London Bridge is falling down, my fair lady. So, you know, you could change the end. I didn't write the end on here. But that was the idea. So then you'd have, if I put the new words to it.
Everyone is in lockdown, in lockdown, in lockdown. Everyone is in lockdown, it's not funny.
And then it would go down to there. So I'm now going to play that verse with my guitar.
Everyone is in lockdown, in lockdown, in lockdown. Everyone is in lockdown, it's not funny. There's no loo roll anywhere, there's no shampoo for my hair. There's no toothpaste, it's unfair, it's not funny.
So you can see there how essentially it's, you know, it's all very simple, but we've taken an existing song, we've changed the words, we've swapped the melody around, and all of a sudden it's a different song. So that's what we were looking at last week. Just as I say, I wanted to just recap on that. The next thing we were doing, if you remember, I started to write a song. I was just sort of putting down just random lyrics. I really went in cold, and I didn't know what I was going to write. And I'd come up with the wind is blowing, the trees are shaking. Changed it to trees are. I had tree is, but trees are shaking. I have to write a song, but I don't know what to sing. I'm playing my guitar. I'm looking around the room. I need to write a song, but I don't know what to sing. Those last two lines, really didn't have any ideas, so I just wrote them down at the time, but with the idea that I'll probably change them. So that's where we're up to. Oh, so that's what I thought, you know, we could look a little bit at that today. Before I started the stream, I did a little bit of preparation. So this song, for the sake of a name for the moment, we'll just call it, I don't know, let's call it Write a Song. It's just called Write a Song. That'll do for now. So we've got, I was just literally playing between those two chords. So we've got C, and it goes to a D minor, and it goes back to the C, and it just was going around. So I never really had a set melody. It was just something along the lines of,
the wind is blowing, the trees are shaking. I have to write a song, but I don't know what to sing. I'm playing my guitar, and I'm looking around the room. I need to write a song, but I don't know what to sing.
So the first thing that, when I looked at it today, I thought I need to change those two last lines because I'm not happy with those. So I came up instead with, I'm looking for something to get me through. So what I thought, I started to play that. So
the wind is blowing and the trees I have to write a song, but I don't know what to sing. I'm playing my guitar, and I'm looking around the room. I'm looking for something to get me through.
And then I went a little bit further, so I thought, okay, I can use those lines. It's just a bit different to what I'd written. But as I just mentioned, we've been using the C, and we've been using the D minor. So at that point, I thought, well, maybe we can bring in the E minor as well. So if you remember when I was going back to the keyboard, we've got chord 1, 2, and 3, so the E minor was the next one along. And I just thought it'll take us somewhere else. So what I came up with is...
The wind is blowing and the trees are shaking. I have to write a song, but I don't know what to sing. I'm playing my guitar and I'm looking around the room. I'm looking for something to get me through.
So what I did there, I went down to an E minor. On that, I'm looking for something to get. And then on that, the word get, I've just kind of let it hang on a little bit over the D minor to
get me through.
So back to the C. You might want to just play between those two chords. Now, today, one of the things I wanted to discuss is that, you know, that's basically a... it's a verse. And when we're looking at like just traditional straight up kind of pop songs, you tend to find that, as you're probably already very well aware, you have like your verse, which is, you know, this bobbing along, telling the story bit. And then a lot of songs then go into like a chorus, and the chorus is usually repeated. It might be repeated a few times at the end. There are other sections that pop up in pop songs too, but today I just wanted to look at the straight up verse and chorus sort of format of a song. And I thought what we could do is look at turning this song into sort of a verse chorus song. So now I want to look at writing a chorus. At the minute, we're just sticking with the three chords. But I thought at this point it would be quite good to just give you like a couple of straight up examples of verse chorus songs. One that did come to mind, let me have a look on here. Okay, there's a song, it's an old song by a singer called Leif Evandros. And it's called Never Too Much. I think it was from like probably around the time I was born, sort of early 80s, long time ago. But the point is, this is just an example song. Especially if you're a young person, you're going to probably be into something very, very different. But what I want to get across here is that it doesn't really matter what the type of music is you're into, but looking at classic song formats. So if you go through anything that you like to listen to, maybe start to analyse, to pull apart the songs you like and listen. All right, so it does this and it does this and it does this and there's a chorus. You know, there might be links, musical links in between the verses and choruses. Anyway, this is just a quick example. So the verse sort of starts off with quite a lot of lyrics in it, actually. So, what is it? I knew that happened. I can't help myself, I don't want nobody else to ever love me. You are my guiding light, my guiding light, my love fantasy. There's a lot of lyrics in this. There's not a minute, hour, day or night that I don't love you. You're at the top of my list because I'm always thinking of you. Just pay notice at the minute. I'm only playing two chords. I still remember in the days when I was scared to touch you. How I spent my daydreaming, planning how to say I love you. As I know that I was leaving, you know, little lyrics, that always helps. And you opened up your door and you told me to come in. And at this point, it goes into the chorus. Oh, my love. And it's just a three-chord song. Thousand kisses from you is never too much. And I just don't want to stop, oh, my love. A million days in your arms is never. much, never too much, never too much. There we go. And it goes back into another verse. So that, oh my love, a thousand. That's the chorus that comes back in after the next verse. And then the song just basically goes out on that chorus. So I guess a chorus of a song is a sort of, it's like a summary, and it's the catchy bit. You might call it a hook. It is just like the defining section of a song. So in the traditional pop song format, because as I said last week, one thing I love about songwriting is like learning all of the kind of set out rules, if you want to call them rules. But then the more you get into it, it's kind of playing around with them and not necessarily following traditional formats. But for now, we're just looking at those traditional formats, just because when you know how to do those, you can move forward and experiment a bit more. Anyway, there's nothing wrong with a classic pop song. Another one would be, let me see, you've got too many pieces of paper. Oh, so you might have heard of a songwriter called Nora Jones. She did a song called I Don't Know Why I Didn't Come. So it goes like this. I don't know why I didn't come. Feel as empty as a drum. I don't know why I didn't come. I don't know why I didn't come. So the verses go around like that. Again, I'm forgetting half the lyrics. So. Played this so many times, but and then what happens is it goes into a chorus, which is my heart is drenched in wine. You be on my mind forever, and then back into another verse. And across an empty sea, I could die in ecstasy, but I'll be a bag of bones, driving down this road alone. I'll, for the sake of it, back into the chorus. Into, I think, an instrumental, whatever it does. But again, it's just showing you that, you know, you have that chorus. It might be that it sort of lifts the song in some way. It's a focal point. So what I thought was, before I set the camera rolling, I started to just have a quick think. And as I did last week, I just started to throw down some word ideas. So I was thinking, what is the general pinnacle of the vibe of what I'm trying to write? What is it I'm trying to write? So I just came up with the words, how do I make it happen when I'm running out of time, before I had to start recording for you guys. I put the pen on paper and I scribbled out a line. And I just thought, oh, maybe I could use that as a chorus. So nothing really set other than that. I know that I've got the C chord, the D minor chord, and the E minor chord, because today those are the only chords I'm using. Normally I might get crazy and start going all over the place, and then I have to reel it in. As I say, don't be afraid to just let yourself go off on a tangent, because you can always reassess what the point you've got to and decide if maybe you need to make it more simple, because often less is more. Anyway, so the wind is blowing and the trees are shaking. I have to write a song, but I don't know what to sing. I'm playing my guitar and I'm looking around the room. I'm looking for something to get me through. Okay, so now I'm going to ask, how do I make it happen? when I'm running out of time, I put the pen on paper and I scribbled out a line. So I thought, well, okay, I've gone back to the C, which is a starting point. That's how I've ended the verse. So maybe now I just jump straight into that new chord, the E minor. And then I might go to the D minor again. And I might just hang on those two. So let's try putting that first line in. How do I make it happen? There's only one way to find out. How do I make it happen? I don't know. When I'm running out of time, I put the pen on the paper and I scribble out a line. Could be that. Oh, maybe. How do I make it happen? When I'm running out of time. It's just, it's trying to find a way to make it a bit catchier. Like, it's not, I'm not feeling that at the minute. So the only thing I can do is just, at this point when I'm writing a song, I just mess around till it's right. How am I gonna make it happen? Okay, I might change the words around a bit, so. How am I gonna make it happen? Okay, I like where that's going to me. La 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 da 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 da. How am I gonna make it happen? When I'm running out of time, I put the pen on. And I scribble out a line. It could be that. It could be something that I put back in the drawer for now and I come back to another day and suddenly it clicks. But it's the start of an idea. It might not be the definitive idea because, you know, you just know when that happens and you can't force these things. So I'm going to just record that as an idea. So last week I was talking about if you have got access to a mobile phone or some other kind of recorder, it might be that one of your parents or whoever you live with might have like an old style dictaphone. I don't know if you've ever seen one of them. It's just like a little sort of device you can click and just record sound onto. You might be lucky enough to have access to a computer or a laptop, in which case you can always record on there. In future weeks, I'm going to be looking at and talking about simple ways to record. I'm not any sort of technological sound recording expert. That's not my thing. But it's good to have some knowledge. There are other videos on here for the people who deal with that who are very good. It's still good to be able to have, to sort of generally find your way around technology a little bit because you'll just find it useful for recording your ideas. If I'm going to do a demo, so for example, I'm working on an album of my own songs at the minute and I go to a studio to record those and somebody who really knows what they're doing records me. But to initially get the ideas down, I've got like a laptop, a USB microphone. I can show you that. Well, in fact, it's recording at the moment, but I have another one. So bear with me. Well, I do have another one somewhere, but basically it's just a microphone that you can plug straight into your laptop. You can download a program called Audacity. And when I'm demoing songs, if I want to put harmonies on them, I just use Audacity. And I find that a really, really useful tool. So, but for now, as I said last week, my day-to-day sort of go-to tool that I record on is just a voice recorder on my phone. There are voice recording apps. If your phone doesn't have one, you can download them for free. But I think most phones do come with some sort of recording device. So mine is called Voice Recorder. It's that simple. I open it up. There's a little red circle on the screen. I'm going to press that and I'm recording. So firstly, I'm just going to make a note so I don't get lost. This is the song that we've been working on. I'm going to record the new chorus idea for whatever we decided to call the song, which I think was, it was just called Write a Song. Okay, so.
How am I gonna make it happen when I'm running out of time? Put the pen on the paper and I scribble out a line.
So I'm gonna just put the verse on there. So
wind is blowing.
I can't even think where that was now. The wind is blowing and the trees are shaking.
Wind is blowing, the wind is blowing and the trees are shaking. I have to write a song. Sing, playing my guitar, and I'm looking around the room. I'm looking for something to get me through. When I'm out of time, put the pad on the paper.
Okay, so that's rough, you know, it's still finding its legs. But another thing last week I talked about is that if I keep going over that, it might sound a bit different every time, but it just starts to, you start to get a feel for the melody. So I know that the first line, the wind is blowing, it's sort of, wind is blowing and the trees are shaking. I know that it's, I've pitched it somewhere around there and it's not quite set yet, but that's where it feels right. I have to write a song when I don't know what to sing. So I know that those lines sort of do that now. That's stuck in my head. Because for me, a lot of this is just internalizing it and absorbing it, and it just seems to stick. But this is what I'm saying. I'm driving in my car and the cat stole my guitar, I think, was something like that. So I don't have a cat, so I could have an imaginary cat. I've got a song about a cat. I'm going to play that to you soon. It was a song I wrote about my mum's cat. Okay, so is it any good? I really couldn't say. How long have we been going for? Oh, we've been going for half an hour. The trees are still and the sky is cold and grey. I'm playing my guitar. I'm playing my guitar, I'm looking around the room. I'll just use those same lines for the moment. Again, you can come back to them and you can change them if you need to. I'm playing my guitar, I'm looking around the room. With lots and lots of lyrics all pushed in there. There are a few that come to mind. I'll talk about those next time. Also, another thing with a pop song is that you often find you have a verse, something called a bridge and a chorus. And the bridge is like a separate little section just lodged between the verse and the chorus. We will explore that a bit more in future too. But I wanted to finish with this song, which is a song I wrote a while ago, and it's called Catty Puss Fatty Puss. It was just a daft song I wrote about my mum's cat. Last week I was speaking to Katie from Cloth Cat, and she mentioned that as I was doing the session, she was sat on the bed and she was looking at a cat, and it started to bring up some ideas where she was singing a song to a cat. So I thought, oh, well, this is a perfect song. So this is called Fatty Puss, Catty Puss. So as I say, if you... Oh, I hope I am there. If you all click refresh, I'm hoping I'm coming through. I'm just seeing a message here from Katie. I seem to be having some streaming problems, so if I've cut off at any point, I do apologise again. Anyway, this is called Catty Puss, Fatty Puss. Cat Catty Puss, you're such a little fatty puss, a furry ball of fat, such a funny cat. You were very spherical, occasionally hysterical, two triangles and a tail. Sitting in the sunshine, not a care. She's gonna rip your face off if you stroke her there. She's a catty puss, such a little fatty puss, chewing on the grass and coughing up a fur ball. She is very spherical, occasionally hysterical, sitting on my chair and molting everywhere. Sitting in the sunshine, watching all the birds fly by. She'd really like to catch them, but they're just too high. Fatty Puss, she's such a little catty puss, rolling on the landing, rolling down the stairs. She is very spherical, occasionally hysterical, fluffy and adorable, ferocious as a bear. Sitting in the sunshine, watching all the birds fly by. She'd really like to catch one, but they're just too high. There's tuna in the kitchen, so why try? Why bother? Life is good. Why bother? Catty Puss, she's such a little fatty puss, a furry ball of fat, such a funny cat. You were very spherical, occasionally hysterical, two triangles and a tail.
That's just a silly song I wrote a few years ago. And speaking on the chorus from, what you might notice with that is that every time I played the chorus, it changed a little bit each time. And that's just another creative sort of take on what you can do with a chorus. It doesn't always have to be exactly the same, but the general vibe was the same. So just go away, you know, I've tried and continue writing some more songs. What I've posted this week, if you looked at my videos last week, I did some vocal exercises. I've done you a new vocal exercise video. And I've also posted another sort of like an extras video where it is just me playing a guitar. And this time I'm playing between, last week I just did C to D minor. This time I'm doing C to D minor to E minor to C. And it's just me playing so that you've got something you could go away and write to. And as I say, I can tell you all these different things, but all that really matters with songwriting is just doing it. And the more you do it, and the more you sort of let your imagination go, and the more you sort of let it carry you to wherever it's carrying you to, then, you know, you'll just get better with time and just keep it real. So I'm just having a quick look. I don't have many comments today, and I'm just concerned that a lot of this video may have been eaten up in the ether. So if there's any problems, I will go back and record anything which may have been lost on this video, and it'll be in my playlist. So take care, everybody. Enjoy songwriting, and I'll see you next week. Bye.